Hello everyone, welcome to this live stream which is with the AICF Secretary Bharat Singh Chauhan. We had the AICF elections recently and it was won by Bharat Singh, who became the secretary, and also Sanjay Kapoor, who became the president. And today the secretary has readily agreed to come on stream and speak with us. You know, we're going to ask him about his plans for Indian chess. And at the same time, you, the viewers, can ask him questions that you would have in your mind. You know, for any sport to thrive and flourish, it's very important to have a strong administration. And as we see, chess has been flourishing in the last few months. It has been on the rise, and the role of AICF becomes even more critical. So without any further delay, I would like to welcome the man of the moment, Mr. Bharat Singh Chauhan. Hello, Bharat Singh ji. How are you?
Thank you. Thank you so much, Sagar, for your wishes.
A huge congratulations, yes, to you for becoming the AICF secretary. Is it like, do you feel a sigh of relief, or you feel now the real work has to begin?
I think the real work will begin now. And for this, I was aiming that as soon as I take over, I can work freely. I can execute my plans for the chess development. And I'm glad that I have won and I'll be able to do my best.
Yeah, well, I have certain pictures which I would like to discuss with you, your plans and all of it. But before going to that, how have been the last few months in this lockdown leading up to the elections which took place on 4th of January? They were quite intense.
Yeah, it was. I'll be very frank with you. It was a terrible time for me, and going for elections, campaigning, and thank God that it was pandemic period. Chess was not much on the ground level, and we are able to now start it again. But we have lost so many things. I'm sure we'll be able to come up things very quickly. We are on business. As you can see, I'm sitting in my office, and it's a very cold evening in Delhi. Temperature is 6-7. I'm sitting in my office and talking to you, and maybe another four hours I'll be here.
Wow. Well, we have certain things to discuss here, and you know, I have a small PowerPoint presentation that I have prepared, which I would like to discuss with you. So first of all, I would like to tell the viewers that if you have any questions, we'll be taking it at the end of the session. So please do send in your questions if there are any for Bharat Singh ji. First of all, Bharat Singh ji, you became the secretary, but also Sanjay Kapoor became the president of the All India Chess Federation. And this happened on the 4th of January. Could you tell us a bit about the president? Because you were the secretary, we know you and your role in Indian chess, but the president is new to Indian chess.
Yeah, I think he's not very new. He's president of UP Chess Association already, and he's supporting UP chess in a big way. Very young man of 45 years, very dynamic, very good ideas, and a lot of new things he want to do. He's already in cricket. He's Kanpur district, chairman of Kanpur district cricket association. So he knows what is a sports administration and how to grow the sport. So we have very intense planning and a lot of work is to be done.
Yeah, it's very interesting that he is also in the cricket administration and now in chess. Do you see that some of the ideas of cricket and his connections there would flow into chess?
I am sure, yes. Because cricket in India is one of the prime sports, and chess is emerging sport. And as you know, chess is also growing, maybe the fastest growing sports in the country. So we have lot of good things happen to Indian chess. So I'm sure his experience in cricket will work.
Wonderful. And also, this is the team that we see right now. There is Sanjay Kapoor as the president. Then we have सिक्स वाइस प्रेसिडेंट्स अनंत, भावेश पटेल, विपनेश भारद्वाज, अजय अजमेरा, ललियान थागा, नियापुंग कोनिया, सेक्रेटरीज योरसेल्फ, जॉइंट सेक्रेटरीज राजेश आर, महेंद्र ढाकल, अतुल कुमार मुगाहो अवोमी, दिलजीत खन्ना, अतनु लहरी एंड ट्रेजरर नरेश शर्मा. व्हाट डू यू मेक ऑफ दिस टीम?
This team, we have out of 15, 14 are chess players.
Okay. They all have a rating, yes?
Yeah, most of them, they have rating and some are unrated, but most of them are chess players.
Wonderful. And actually, they are from different parts of the country, yes? Example, I see that Northeast is very well represented here.
Yes. That was our, even last 3 years, we have done a lot of work in Northeast. It was one of the prime concern for me because Northeast was not doing well in chess. Now we have to work more there.
And also, you know, there was an intense rivalry before the elections. There were two factions, but I see these pictures here. We see the ex-president of AICF, Venkat Rama Raja, also a good friend, DV Sundarji. So you after the elections ended, you went and met them. How was it?
Yes. As soon as the election results were out, I went to Chennai. We went there to do some work with the bank and office. I decided to go and meet them personally because as FIDE's slogan is there, we are one family. And you know, now, as far as I'm concerned, we want AICF administration legal free, politics free, and most of the energy should be put into sports for the promoting of sports. And it is important to meet all of them and say that there is no hard feeling. Let's work together. And I'm glad things are moving in the right direction.
Yeah. And I guess they have agreed also, as we know, Ramco has played a critical role. They were the sponsors of the Indian team at the 2018 Olympiad as well. So
yes,
it's wonderful. One of the moves that you made in the first week itself, becoming the secretary, is getting Vishy Anand on the board of advisors. How did that happen?
See, it was a long time. It was in my mind that we should have Vishy on a board. It is going to help Federation. Of course, his experience, rich experience, will help Federation and Indian chess. It has helped, Anand has helped Indian chess in a big way. But being in administrative body as advisor, it is going to help us further, and I'm sure it'll do well. And it was not difficult because Anand is always ready for the chess promotion. The moment I requested him, he said, we'll work together. And it was very nice of him that he has agreed. I don't know, previously we have never tried this.
Yeah.
Maybe certain reasons, but now he has agreed and we are going to work together.
Well, it's wonderful. You also, FIDE, you know, had Anand and Kramnik on their board of advisors. So it's very nice that AICF also has the legend on the panel. Would there be more advisors in this board, or how is it?
Yeah, we are planning to induct some big business people so that when we start Chess League, they can be useful.
Okay, we'll come to that question as well. One of the most interesting ones. As we saw, you were in the Chennai office of AICF here along with some of the members of your team and began working. But there will also be an office in Delhi. How will it be?
Yes, we have an office in Delhi, the place where I'm already sitting here.
Okay.
And we have, there will be both the office will function. And certain works will be handled by Chennai office, certain work will be handled by Delhi office, and we are going to closely work together for this.
Cool. Before I go on with the aims and vision of AICF in the next few years, I wanted the viewers to also know a bit about you. You are a very passionate chess player. Would that be right to say?
Yes.
I've seen you playing a lot of chess every time you are in some. In fact, if right now we wouldn't have been having COVID, the Delhi Open would be one of the biggest event in India would have been taking place right now, and you would be busy playing against someone over there.
See, that this period I'm really missing. These tournament days are the best days in a year for me. I play a lot of chess, meet a lot of people, good tournament, a lot of players come, we meet all the players, friends, and play a lot of chess. Unfortunately, this year it is not happening.
Yeah. So do you make it up with by playing online, or how is it?
I play sometime, but after 4th January, let me be very honest, I have played just 5-6 games because I'm working 16 to 18 hours a day because a lot of things to be done, and the losses which we made in past 1 year because of that fight, I just want to cover up, and a lot of things to be done. I just cannot explain how quickly we want to move on to.
Yeah, that is very exciting. And you are not just right now the president, the secretary of AICF, but also you have different roles when it comes to FIDE. You are also in the technical commission. You're also in, in Commonwealth Chess, also in Asian Chess Federation. So can you tell us a bit about your roles in different chess organizations?
Technical commission in general, there are a lot of issues we discuss, like tie breaks and a lot of rules and school chess. You know, basically, it is not only technical things, but a lot of other things also. So it is a very important commission, and we are a group of people which we work. I am chairman, but everybody contribute in the commission. That is for the commission. We do, like recently we brought in one rule, force majeures, because I hope you remember in Aeroflot Open, there was a bomb scare, and then they had to abandon one round, and there was no time to compete. So such kind of rules we discuss, and we put it to FIDE Congress, and they approve it. So with the experience and situation, we are working on this. Asian Chess Federation is mainly for the Asian activities. We do how the activities and promotion in Asia. So I'm basically doing on various fronts.
Yeah.
Working. But chess in India, chess in AICF is my main priority, and I'm working 75% of my time for Indian chess.
Amazing. The post of secretary is an honorary one. So do you also spend time doing something in your profession or some other work, or all of your time is dedicated to chess?
Now I'm 61 and financially very sound and stable. So I want to do a thing which I dreamt, and I feel that I should work for a chess. It's a long story. We have traveled in train bathroom for 48 hours to play National Junior when it got canceled. So the day I decided that I'll work for chess, and now I have, I'm solid in all the ways, so I can contribute a lot of time and work for chess and chess players.
So like almost all of your time will go towards chess, right?
Yes.
Now.
Yes.
Fantastic. In the lockdown.
Not almost, the every moment of my life goes for chess.
Okay. That's wonderful to know. In the lockdown, something very special happened. I'm sure you were following it. The online Olympiad was held. The Indian team won the gold medal. 12 wonderful chess players of India, we won the gold in this event. At the same time, there was a huge interest while watching this tournament. There were nearly 68,800 people watching it live, with Samai doing, you know, hosting the show. Myself, Amruta, and lot of other people joining in, as you can see in the picture, Vladimir Kramnik. What are your thoughts on this entire chess boom, online chess boom that has taken place?
First of all, I want to admit that I was one of the 68,000. I was watching all your streams, and I was texting you certain issues. And first round, there was an internet failure with Vidit and Humpy. Then we immediately corrected it, not as a ISF secretary, as a chess lover. We spoke to some sponsors and we offered them to play in five-star hotels. I was following each and everything, and the standing comedians coming and doing chess. It was really very famous. And I also see a lot of big people following. I saw a tweet from Mahindra.
Yeah, exactly. This is what I mean. After he was one of the viewers. And then he tweeted saying someone messaged Shrut Shah saying help to organize Indian Chess League to make chess reach a new height. And he says happy to talk.
Yes. And we are starting the dialogue with him for your information, because for Chess League, I don't want to waste any of the opportunity, and we are working on it.
So you know, it's been a long standing dream of Indian Chess to have the Chess League. And also, it was one of your aims in the when you were the secretary in the last tenure. What do you say about this time? Do you think it's going to happen soon? How is it placed?
Definitely, yes. I think within 6 months, we'll have something very concrete to have the chess league. Because earlier, there were some reservations. When you work in democracy, you have to listen to others and their point of view. Still, there is a democracy, but now we have the majority of the people are believe in progressive agenda, and league is one of our prime concern, and we are going to have it within 6 months. We'll be able to fetch something good for Indian chess.
Beautiful. And how do you see right now the online chess, as you mentioned about streaming? You know, we have our top Indian GMs, Adiban, Vidit, Surya Ganguly. There's also the comedians who have Samai, Biswa, Vaibhav, Anish Giri, Rajabhav. All of these people have come in and are doing some very interesting work in the field of streaming. Online tournaments are taking place. What is your take on this? Do you think online chess is something that you want to focus on, or you are looking at the over-the-board chess resuming soon?
I, as a chess player, I personally feel the online chess was a need of the hour, because there was nothing happening. But I feel we should get into the same classical way of chess. And as soon as restrictions are removed, AICF will start playing those tournaments. But this period has given another module, which is online chess, and especially mixing with comedians. Top players are coming. I heard Anish Giri coming, Adiban talking, Rajabhav talking. It was really very interesting, and which can generate a lot of interest among youngsters. It was a very good idea, but I'm not saying we'll go back to the same formula again, but I think both the formulas we should work for the development of chess. Online chess, my only apprehension, and most of the people have the same problem, the cheating concerns. Many people are talking about it, but we have to find a way to stop this, and then online chess is good and easy to conduct.
How do you overcome this? Because this is the key issue, the cheating, the people using external help when playing online. And you being a member of the technical commission as well, I know the online chess was not a big part of technical commission at that point, but is there something that that is going on in FIDE or in AICF about this, or it's like, let's wait for a while, let's see if a vaccine comes up? How is it? How is the thought process?
First of all, I'll say in FIDE already there is a fair play commission which look after all the cheating things. In technical commission, we have not much role to play in this. Some device we approve, we send it to the Fair Play Commission, and they decide whether they can do it. But in India, I feel we were planning some kind of national championship, like computer centers are there at most of the cities. We'll have some 20, 30, 50, how many players. So locally they can travel without any fuss. And those centers, we put arbiters to monitor, and they play online.
Okay.
And the computers should have only chess playing. No, all other functions should be disabled. So it's very much possible. We are thinking to start some kind of national championship till the time the restrictions are not eased out.
But this is a very interesting concept. Don't you think there is too much of infrastructure investment that needs to be done, because every city needs a center and all of it? Do you think it's feasible?
I think very much feasible. I had a discussion, somebody in TCS, they have centers, nearly 600 to 700 centers in the country, even the district headquarters. We already had a discussion with them, but you know, our elections, and now we are in working mode. It is feasible, and there is no investment. We can make them partners, and they can, only thing is 50 centers, 50 arbiters. See, arbiters are very important for the country and for the game. And 50 arbiters means at least they will get some earning. Players will get some prize money. And there will be a tournaments without cheating.
Fantastic.
So this is what is my opinion. And we think to do this if things are not eased out.
It's actually a path between online chess and over-the-board chess. Somewhere in between, and could lead to, I think, very interesting events, and also national championship, as you said, can be held in this format.
Yeah, maybe we'll start for you under 25 and under 19, because kids under 7, under 9, we cannot have this thing, but definitely we'll have for the mediocre thing, which are players above 16 or above 15, we can have.
Very interesting. While we are speaking about this, there are a few super chats which are coming up. So I wanted to just ask a few questions from there. Akshay Nathu says, greetings, Mr. Chauhan. We have seen GMs from South India, Maharashtra, but UP, Bihar, Kashmir are still to develop. Is there a plan for grassroots level changes there so that we can see GMs from these areas?
See, I always felt when 2005, we had 10 GMs and now we have 66, 67 GMs. We never focused on making GMs. Let me be very honest with you. We always thought in AICF that we should develop chess in all nook and corner, and we should create a base, more and more players. That will attract everything. This is what happened. A lot of tournaments, a lot of GM tournaments, and players were created. Now, about the planning of these tournament where we can create GMs in UP, Bihar, and Jammu and Kashmir. We are going to start a chess in school program, and we are going to target all the districts. Even district headquarters, we are planning tournaments. See, it's very important that you don't become GM in a day. You need to start chess in all the district, grassroots level. Some players will come, some talent will come. Then plan A, plan B, plan C. That way school program is being designed. And once the chess start at grassroots level, definitely GMs will come from Northeast, Jammu and Kashmir, all the corners of the country.
Very interesting. I'll come to the chess in schools questions in a bit, but these are some of the points that you have mentioned in your vision of the next 3 years that you are going to work. So can we go over them, each point a bit? You can tell us a bit about it, like more support to state associations. And is it like AICF is going to give them more funds? How is it?
See, first of all, we are not going to give any cash money to any state association. We are going to provide them support for offices, technology, helping them to conduct tournaments, helping them to conduct trainer seminar, training for trainers, all grassroots level, we are going to support them. But this will be spending a lot of money on this, but AIC will be spending on this.
Okay.
No cash payments.
All right. Got it. What about corporate sponsorships? I think this is something that chess requires in big measure. What has been the reason that corporates have not come in big way into chess? I know that a few chess connoisseurs, lovers have been supporting the game, but if you look at on a big scale, corporate funding has been missing.
Yes, it was missing, and now things are different what it was 5 years before. We have a lot of interest in chess. Chess has become popular, and right approach. We have to work like a corporate. I'll share with you, first time we are going to have revenue officer for AICF.
Mm-hmm. And what will be his role?
See, he will see the opportunities where we can get funding, corporates, what are the corporates we can involve, what are the corporates we can target. Like I'll tell you, for chessing school, some apps are there already there into education, Unacademy, Baiju, and there are various organizations. We are going to target that, how we are going to target, how we are going to. So we are going to work as a corporate. We are going to work in the same style, and I'm sure we'll be able to, because unless until we get the corporate funding, we cannot run our program, because chess in school alone is around 4 crores or 5 crores in a year.
Yes.
We plan to spend. So we have to increase our earning, and unless until we increase the earning, we cannot run our programs.
The chess in school is one of those programs which seems like, you know, the most natural for a game of chess. Because, you know, if it is introduced in schools, it will reach out to the maximum number of people. But somehow it has not been, we have not been able to make it work in India. What change would you bring about this time?
I'll tell you why it is not working. We are just working in metros. Chess in school is done only in metros, not to the grassroots level. I think we should go to the all district headquarters, run it from the grassroots level, and we are going to support chess, state chess associations for chess in school. Like, we are going to give a person who is going to work, AICF will pay its salary, we are going to have a mobile apps in different languages for chess in school, and we are going to work on grassroots level. So it could not take place because we never intend to fund this project. I just cannot go to any sponsor, give me this money, I want to run chess in school. AICF has got money, we are going to spend it, invest it, and I am sure within 1 year it will be doubled.
Fantastic. Okay. Government funding, as we see in point number three, is one of the most critical sources of revenue for the All India Chess Federation. As I think we had mentioned, last year itself, government had, I don't know the exact amount, it was around 4 crore rupees that the government had supported Indian chess with. But how do you see that shaping up? Because there have been certain problems there.
I think government funding is not the issue. The programs we put in front, the ideas we put in front, chess in school and various other, government funding won't be a problem. We are going to get good funding from the government.
Okay. And I think one of the problems that has been facing is about the Arjuna Awards. And a lot of our players, Arjuna, Dronacharya Awards, nothing has been forthcoming in the last 7 years. How do we fix that?
I'll tell you, first I will tell you how it had happened and why it is happening. There was a court case in, I think, Delhi High Court, which wanted a transparency in Arjun Award and Dronacharya. Government introduced a point system. Cricket was an exceptional. So all other sports point system, in that point system, we are the non-Olympic sports. It was very difficult to compete with the Olympic sports. So our players are not getting Arjuna and Dronacharya. We had written to the government, and but now more aggressively, we are going to talk to the government, because chess is one of the very popular game, and it was invented in India. They have to give the same status like cricket. As far as these awards are concerned, I'm sure we'll be able to fetch this goal.
Yeah, there have been some, as you said, Smart Girl events and also Chess for Everyone. This was held previously as well. I remember there were a few events. 50,000 rupees were given to different district association or state associations, and they held Smart Girl events, which was a very refreshing change because a lot of girls got to play there. New talents came up.
Yeah, it is not only the tournaments. We provide coaching for girls, exclusively for girls under Smart Girl. And we are also funding a lot of other things like women round robin tournament and all that. And not only Smart Girl, there is Chess for Everyone. This project, you can play rating tournament without paying any entry fee. Also, under this project, we are going to provide coaching to the basic level. Even if you have 1,000 rating or 1,100, we are going to provide you free training under this project.
Very interesting. You know, a lot of people who are watching this, they have got interested in chess in the lockdown, and they are very interested to get their FIDE rating. And they say, you know, will the fees be reduced for FIDE rating tournaments? How would that be?
See, I'm saying that Chess for Everyone, we plan to have 20 tournaments in a year. So you can always play in those tournaments without any entry fee.
With no entry fee.
With no end. This Chess for Everyone is without entry fee.
Yeah, but then how does it sustain? The basically it's through sponsorships and that's how the revenue comes in, yeah?
Isaga, let me tell you, we as a federation, we have to do something for different part of society. This is one of the thing. There are many people who cannot afford entry fee, but they want to play rating tournament. For them, we have introduced this. 20 rating tournaments will be held. But now we have decided in place of holding it in cities, we are going to have in all district headquarters. We are going to choose some district to make chess popular in the rural areas or grassroots level. So we are going to have these tournaments there.
Okay, so there will also be a lot of training camps. I think it's very important that also the arbiters and trainers grow in the country, not just chess players.
See, I'll give you a figure. Last 2 years, we trained 600 trainers with the help of Government of India, and certain trainer seminars were held under AISF funding. Now we are going to have refresher course for trainers every 6 months. All the certified trainers will have to undergo under refresher course, because once you take the training, you pass, you get a certificate, then you don't get refreshed for coaching ideas. So we are going to do such things like arbiters. We already have a seminar, refresher seminar. Every arbiter of the country has to go for refresher seminar, unless and otherwise he will not be given any assignment. He cannot become even arbiter in the rating tournament.
Okay.
So these kind of things we are going to do. And trainers camp, as you know, past 3 years maximum trainers camp, training camps we had. One of the camps Anand also attended, Hampi also attended.
Yes.
So for the top players, and now as I said about Chess for Everyone, we are going to have free coaching for the normal players, even 1,000 rating or unrated, we are going to do this.
And it's mentioned you will use online tools better. How is it? Because, you know, last year, like in the last tenure, you had mentioned that AICF would come out with its app. And would that still be a plan, or would you use other tools which are already available? How would it be?
See, we had an app, but there were certain issues with the data, our players' data. So we have just put it down a few days back from Google Play Store. We are going to have, which will be managed by AICF, and Chess in School, we are going to have a mobile application in various languages. Right from the beginning, players can learn.
Okay.
So at least we need to have some 6-7 languages mobile app, and a lot of other things. We are going to do a lot of online seminars, online training camps, even most of the meetings and district meetings. We are going to do it online because it is easier, cost effective, and also you can monitor. See, if district association meeting is happening online, I can coolly log in and check what they are discussing and what is their plans. But when it is a normal meeting, I cannot travel there in that district. Hmm. Like recently, we had a tournament in Pakistan, we had a tournament in Jammu and Kashmir, Kupwara. 200 players participated with the help of Indian Army. I could go through online and see how they are managing and all that. If you ask me, go to Kupwara or some other place in interior part of the country, it is difficult. But now I can see, we can help other countries also through online. So I personally feel technology is an important tool to develop chess. Maybe that is a chess based India is a living example for this.
Thank you for that. Krishna Char has asked, any plans for disabled chess improvement? I think in Indian chess, blind chess, physically disabled, also deaf and mute chess, these are the three categories of disabled chess. Do you have any plans related to that?
See, we have a federation for visually people. We have a federation for disabled people. They are working on it. Whatever program they give us, we support them. But All India Chess Federation, let me be very honest, we work on these fields through their federations.
Right.
And we support them. If whatever they ask, we support them.
Okay. There will be more NOM events. That's what is mentioned. I think India already has around 6 to 8 NOM tournaments that happen in the year.
Yes, we want to increase it by 12 because still there is a gap. Northeast, we want to have one. We want to have some time in the upper hill area, Himachal and Kashmir. So we want to make at least 12 tournaments, UP and Bihar. Now president is from UP. So I want to make at least 12 tournaments.
Mm-hmm. Interesting. Okay, we spoke about chess in schools. I think that one will be very critical program for Indian chess. Reduction in tournament registration fee, is that the 20 free events or in general, the registration fee, there would be a reduction?
See, it is basically, we have the entry fee. You cannot charge more than 0.5% of entry
price
fee.
Fund.
Yeah, the price fund. We are going to reduce it further down. I know it is a very challenging job for the organizer in this difficult time, but one has to look for sponsorship. We cannot charge players to run the tournament. That is what I feel, and we are going to work on this direction.
It's a shift in approach, I believe, because until now it was always like the players have to be paying the entry fee, the players have to be paid the registration fee. There's an AICF registration every year that has to be done. So that from there, I see that the shift is towards getting sponsorships, maybe AICF putting in its funds.
Yes. See, I'll tell you, we have to grow our base, more and more players. I feel now today 250 registration, I'll be very happy if there is no registration. If we have today, we have nearly 90,000 registered players. If I have 5 lakh registered players, maybe 10 rupees or 50 rupees is enough to get this money. Mm. So I'll be very happy. I want to get more and more people to the game so that sponsorship will come, chess will become more popular. All the people who are involved in sports, a bookseller, a chess pieces producer, or a lot of people who are working in chess, they will get benefited.
Okay.
So I'll tell you, we are working very professionally. We are going to have a intelligence wing, which is going to look for the revenue ideas and where we are not performing well.
Hmm.
You know, ICICI Bank, they have intelligence unit about their business. So similar, I was just reading all this. So I just talked to some people and what are the areas, I'll tell you, like registration. Last year, nearly 85,000 registered players were there. And what happens, the renewal of registration is 35,000. So 50,000 is not renewing their registration. We found out some of the people have dropped out because the payment failure, or they could not do it online. Some of the people visited our website, they did not register. So we have to make the things very easy and find out why they did not come. That itself will, if the people who have dropped out have come to the site, tried for payment gateway and did not register, if we are able to catch them, our revenue will go up by 50 lakhs. So there are a lot of gray areas where we have to find out by improving things, by making employees accountable, we can make, we can just generate our revenues. Maybe 2-3 crores we can easily generate by efficient measures.
Yeah, also the fact that we have 85 to 90,000 registered players is quite a low number, considering that India is such a huge country and there's a chess boom that is happening. I believe that this number will grow in the years to come.
Yes, it is very unfortunate, and we are going to have registration drive and chess in school, and of course for the school kids registration is going to be different, and we are going to have more and more registration. More registration is a revenue to the district association, revenue to the state association, revenue to the federation. Everybody will get benefited. We are not going to charge school children 200 or 250 rupees. We are going to minimum amount with the facility. They can use mobile app, learning chess. So we are making more numbers. I believe if more numbers, we can generate more money, sponsors will come and chess will grow. And not only this, by teaching chess to the younger people, you are doing something for the country, because most of the people are on the mobiles or a lot of games they are playing, which unwanted games, unwanted use of internet. But if you are teaching chess, I feel if you are teaching chess, working for chess, bringing chess to so many people, it is a great work for the country. Personally agree.
True. We spoke about the support to the states for conducting state level events. I think AICF would support that as well. Yes.
Yes.
And group insurance for AICF registered personnel. I found this quite an interesting point. What is it about?
See, first we were thinking all the registered players, but we discussed with a lot of insurance companies and all. I feel at least our top players should be registered, and the people who are working for AICF, like arbiters and trainers, they should be insured. Because I'll tell you one incident, what happened, one of the arbiters got heart attack and lot of issue. He had to spend a lot of money. Of course, we help whatever minimum way we could do. But in my opinion, those who are working in tournaments, national championships and all that, we should ensure them in case of certain problems that can be taken care of.
Right. Right. And purification of data with FIDE and AICF, I believe that there are a lot of players, and I also saw in the chat that, oh, I sent a picture and it was not uploaded and all of this. I think there are a lot of record issues. Yes.
Yes, there are multiple IDs, there are multiple FIDE IDs, there are multiple AICF IDs. Some people put monkey, because of most of the people, they don't have photos, they will put monkey or cat or something. But now we have made it that it is mandatory to have the photo, so that double ID can be checked, and we are going to just sort out all these issues.
Yeah, you spoken about transparency and accountability in appointment of arbiters and coaches. How would that work? Also, last year we saw that Indian team had many coaches who came in, taught. I believe that there were some very good international coaches who came in. How would the appointment of coaches work this time?
See, we already have started working on this. but still certain gray areas were there, certain tournaments, some of the tournaments players raised some issues. So we are going to be more careful, and we are going to be, there are going to be a separate trainers commission in AICF.
Okay.
So the power will be given to them, whom to appoint, whom not to appoint, and they will look into it, because we don't want to get into any problems, because we want players very comfortable. You know, 2018 Olympiad, trainers working from India, working with them, everything, everyone should be comfortable with the players. Players should be comfortable with the trainers. So we have to see all those aspects, and real coaches will go. Some of the federations, let me share, let the people understand. Probably chess is the only federation which has got maximum trainers, genuine trainers sending. But most of the federation, they are sending their office bearers, their state association office bearers. But in AICF, genuine coaches are sent in by and large.
Yashwant Rai says AICF can hold inter-school AICF tournament to promote chess in schools. That's where the development of sports could begin. Do you think so? A national level inter-school tournament that could generate a lot of interest.
See, already we have a school event, school national schools, which generate nearly 1,000 or more than 1,000 players. We were planning a team event, that is inter-school team event. So we were planning, and we passed it in one of the meetings, but by after that this pandemic started, we already have the team event, school, national school team event. So which will get more players.
And yeah, that would be nice. A national level team event for school kids.
Yeah.
Yeah, coming to this Chess League and Super GM events. In fact, 2018 was when the first Tata Steel event happened in India. And then 2019, it continued. It's unfortunate that we couldn't have one in 2020. But yeah. I think it's very essential, seeing that these young talents in our country, like Pragnananda, Nihal Sareen, Raunak, Gukesh, all of these young talents, the main thing is the opportunity for them to play against the best players in the world. Do you think that this is something that you are looking at, top tournaments for these youngsters?
The Chess League and the top tournaments, both the programs which will give opportunity to our players to play against the stronger players from different countries, top players. Like Tata Steel, you said, we are going to have some more chess tournament. We are working on a tournament, online tournament, between five countries, that is called BRICS. So we are already in touch with sponsors, and we are working on it. Very soon we'll be announcing it.
When would it happen, if it does, this online event?
It will be online event. It will be online. First BRIC tournament.
BRICS, yeah.
Yeah. So we are on it. And there are certain other tournaments which will take place online. And there are two. See, world is suffering. Everyone is suffering. But still, chess community, chess game should go on whatever way we can. But Chess League, I'm sure it is going to be a wonderful thing for Indian chess players. Lot of money will come, and our young talent will be like cricket IPL. A lot of youngsters are product of IPL. So the same way we are going to have IPL, and lot of money for players. I'm sure people will get interested if some players are making money, youngers are making money. So definitely more people, league will have more opportunities for young chess players.
Timelines for AICF staff. Do you think people can join in and, you know, join AICF, work for it? How would it work? Like, to be.
When we were talking about this, first thing, let me be very honest. Our present staff, we had certain mindset, certain issues. I have told them the red tapism should end. When you get first email from a person, it has to be addressed and sorted out immediately. Then second thing was anybody can contribute, and we are going to have staff through advertisement and accountability. When I pay you, I want this thing to be done. It has to be done. Whatever you are, it has to be done. And no harassment. People are calling, chasing. A lot of things are happening. But now I personally feel it has to be clear, and we have to work very professionally and corporate style.
Do you think players' grievance cell is a practically feasible thing to do? Because, you know, so many players across India would have issues.
Yes. See, that's a easier way for Federation to get rid of this. Have a players' council. All the grievances, players demanded. Let the players' committee decide what are the tournaments, what are the grievances, what coach, associations, state associations, all that. Let them decide and send it to the AICA. So it is basically players are dealing players issue. We are going to have a players' council, which is going to address all their problems, issues, and their demands.
There will be a players' council that AICF themselves will have?
Yes, we are going to have a players' council, okay, which will look after all the matters related to players.
And there the chess players would be part of it, and they would, you know, this is something which has always been recommended, yeah, to have some kind of a player's body that fights for the rights of the players.
See, I will tell you, we are going to have a players' council, which will have all kind of players, some GM, some IM, some women, and some lower rated players. So the interest, players' interest for all the categories are taken care. Because when you have all top players, they will talk about only round robin high category tournament. So when you have a smaller player, lower rated, they will talk below tournament. So we are going to have a very vast players' council, which will decide all this.
Okay. Interesting. Ankit Chaudhary says, when will Indian players start participating again in over-the-board tournaments abroad? Other sports bodies are getting government support to send players outside India.
See, I don't know. You have to check with the Home Ministry website. We cannot travel outside, especially from India. There are regulations that you can travel only in Vande Bharat flights and playing for tournaments and all. Not many people are traveling outside India from India. As soon as the government allow us to participate, we are definitely going to have. Funding is not the issue. We have been already doing it. Our junior team, sub-junior team, senior team, I think in past, most of the events we were sending, and that will be done. It's not a big issue.
Here you mentioned about committees being formed. I think committees is something that is the way FIDE has been functioning. They have various committees. Until now, I don't think AICF had different committees, right, under itself.
So again, there were a lot of committees, but you need to change your thinking. Earlier, the AICF secretary or the set of office bearers were dealing everything. You have to make committee more responsible, more accountable, and you have to give them freedom to work whatever they want. Because it's very important that they function. Otherwise, there is no point to have committee. So we are going to have committees and give them power to decide, and then we'll act on this. Mm-hmm. So there are certain very interesting things we are bringing. The Players' Council is one of the things. Second thing is that is my way of thinking, and I am going to put it in the general body. We are planning to have an arbitration council in AICF. That means before going to court, you have to come there and decide your disputes. Because a lot of the state association and AICF itself, we had a long, long legal battle. Why to waste money and players' money? I feel that should be arbitration matter. There are a lot of issues, somebody cheating, so many issues are there. So we put a retired judge, let them put their case to him, And we, instead of going to court, arbitration council is better way of saving money and saving chess.
Mm-hmm. True.
So that is one idea. Players council is another idea. All the things, all the major issues will have this.
And
one more, yeah. One more thing, Sagar, I want to tell you about women chess. Women chess, Smart Girl is just a small initiative, but we aim to make women chess more lucrative because women are not doing well all over the world. And we want to make more lucrative so that more and more women players come and play chess in our country.
So there will be more women events in the coming years?
Yes, more event with the same prize money. Because if you see the tournament, there is a tournament, men prize is 10 lakh and women prize is, total prize is 1 lakh. So that disparity will have to go and we'll have more tournaments for women. I think we have lot of vision, lot of things are not written in this, which we are discussing. And yes. I'm sure we'll be able to do it.
Yeah. Well, I was going through all these points that you had mentioned. And, you know, we've also spoken about chess in schools here for the next 3 years, 10 lakhs to each state association. That would be very interesting. There's also a very interesting idea which you have said to, you know, the inter-school college events with state education department, then chess taught to school teachers, then chess in teachers training institution. You know, these are things which are looking at chess to be introduced in our schools and colleges.
Yes. See, first thing I want to tell you very clearly, that 10 lakh is a higher limit. We are not going to pay any cash, hard cash. We are going to, as I said, we are going to help them with the technology, with the employment, with the trainers and everything. We'll support them because generally state associations, they don't have the money. They cannot run chess in school program. They cannot impart free training. So AISF is going to help them in district level teacher program or all other chess in school. And we are willing to spend 10 lakh rupees on one association. So it's amount to be around 3 crores for 1 year.
Yeah.
And then again, we have people to monitor this proper professional staff. So it is going to be 4 crores.
Mm-hmm. That is going to be a major investment there. And chess kits to schools in remote areas and also a center of excellence in Northeast India. That is interesting.
See, very remote areas, there are no chess boards and pieces people can't afford. So we are going to provide them. But so far we were doing it through sponsors, like one of the central minister distributed some 15,000 chess sets in Himachal Pradesh, Anurag Thakur.
Hmm.
Similar way, we are going to request many people and funding needs to be done for these things. And something AISF will contribute. But it will be only in the remote areas where people cannot afford. And what is the other thing you said?
Chess in schools. The inter-school and college events with state education department, chess taught to school teachers, chess in teachers training institutions. So you're trying to get chess into places where it can reach to a wider audience. The difficulty here is how to implement this. I think that is the key question.
Yes, I'll tell you. See, I personally feel, and most of the people in our team now, the elected team feel, that numbers of chess players, chess playing people should go up, then only sports can grow. The only way to increase the number is chess in school. You go to schools, you go to colleges, you go to institutes, bring more and more players, make easier things, make game very easy, things easy so people can join chess. Like recently, the Queen's Gambit, chess has become very popular, lot of inquiries. So, and this pandemic period, chess has really become popular and we have to encash it. I'm sure we'll be able to do it with these programs. But Chess in School is one of the dream projects which All India Chess Federation is looking for to increase the number. I know we have failed many times. Yes. We tried this version, that, but we never had such a strong funding. Now we have a funding, AISF has the money, we have certain corporate assurance for Chess in School, we have certain sponsors assurance. So first time we have the money for Chess in School, so it will be more easy to work and hire professionals to run this program. Mm-hmm. And Northeast, past 2 years, I hope you have seen that we are doing a lot of work in Northeast. We have trainer seminar, many trainer seminar, many arbiter seminar. Northeast is an area that one of person who has asked me why there are no GMs in these places. So we are going to work together with Northeastern Sports Council and lot of activity in Northeast, because Northeast game like chess is more easy to play because the fields are not there, cricket field or hockey field or football field, it's difficult to get. Chess is easy and more people can adopt. So we are going to invest heavily in Northeast states. We'll have a center there which will have, probably will have a separate GM throughout the year working for Northeastern states for training. Hmm. And also proper arbiters, and also we are going to encourage them for the tournaments, I mean various tournaments.
Very interesting. And I think there are, as you mentioned, your boost to non-active states. Is it true, like right now you have 18 active state associations in India?
If you ask me, I feel only 10 states are very active. For me, you should have an international tournament. You should have more than 2,000 rated active players in your state. Somehow it is not happening, but now we have a funding. We are going to support them. So definitely we can push it and all the states will be active.
Yeah. Yeah, well, this is looking all very exciting, Bharat Singh ji. I have to agree to it. These are 27 points that you have mentioned are the vision of AICF in the coming 3 years. I'm sure that there are some more points and which will be added to it. Just on a final note, I would like to say, you know, when you became the secretary back in 2017, at that point also we had spoken to you, and we had, these are the 15 points that you had mentioned at that point. What do you think is the difference this time as compared to your last tenure? Is it the same, or how do you see it?
No, it is not the same. Maybe out of 15, we were able to implement 10 or 12 of last year's program. But this year, we have said 27. I'm sure it will be 37 or 40. We are going to do it because we completely have the control. And I've told our team that you are free to do 10% politics, but 90% you have to work for the progress of the game. And all of us have to forget about what happened elections, what politics, and start working for chess. And that means we need results. See, such a ambitious program, such an aggressive program, we all have to work together and work hard. So I'm sure with everybody with the same idea and same progressive thinking, we can achieve this. Mm-hmm.
Great. Before we call it a day, there are a few questions that are there in the chat. I would like to just take a couple of them. Akhil Khare says, what are your views on chess being added to Khelo India, which is conducted every year?
I think we had a discussion and they have added already Khelo India.
Yes, it is already added. That's what he mentions. What are your thoughts? Like, it's already a part of Khelo India.
Yeah, it is very important how you execute. So now I'm an elected secretary. I'll go to the government of India and tell them how to implement, because they were selecting people from schools, and there are a lot of issues. But we are going to tell them how chess and chess players can get benefited from Khelo India, the cash awards, the schemes. Earlier, there used to be a talent search. When chess has become part of Khelo India, they'll be entitled for these kind of scholarships. There'll be a lot of issues which will be resolved, but execution is more important. Then we are going to have a meeting soon, because today only we have submitted our election papers to the Government of India. I'm sure as soon as things get clear in a couple of weeks, we'll have series of meetings with various programs, including Arjun Award, cash awards to the players, foreign tournaments funding, international tournament funding, chess in school funding, and trainers. Everything we are going to talk with the government.
Yeah, that is wonderful. Ammai Nigudkar says, how are you going to stop sandbaggers?
It's a difficult question.
For all the people who do not know what sandbaggers means, there are rating cutoff events which happen in India, let's say under 1800, under 1600, and many of the players deliberately reduce their rating so that they can take part in these events and then win high prize money.
See, there was a formula we adopted in Delhi International. Last 1 year, you should, if you are playing a tournament below 1600, last 1 year, you should not have crossed to 1600 and all that. So the similar formula, similar thing look right to me, because 1 year, nobody is going to wait to win just below 1600 tournament or reduce it. Once, even if you achieve 1600 and you reduce it by in 4 or 5 tournaments, then you cannot play. So same kind of thing we are planning to do.
Mm-hmm. Okay, this is, I think, yeah, one of the important things when it comes to rating cutoff events. But a question which all the people in the chat, a lot of them are asking, is when will over the board tournament start in India? I think if it was in your control, you would have started it immediately. Maybe, is it like waiting for the vaccine? What is it?
No, I will not say we are waiting for vaccine. The day government says you can run the tournament, we'll run the tournament. And if it is a rating tournament, I'll play the first tournament, because I'm really sick of online tournament. I want to the first over the board tournament. I want to really play a tournament, and that is the case with every chess player. As soon as government allows us, the same day we'll announce the tournament.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and also I think at that point also the calendar would come out. I mean, right now there's nothing that can be said on this matter.
No, calendar, we are going to tell our all states that complete your state selections, start from by May or something, whether online, the formula I gave that you can have the centers in various.
Yeah.
Same way, complete the selection tournaments. So because as soon as the restrictions are removed, we'll have the national championship. Whether over the board or the system, I told you, because we need to have tournaments, national tournament, and these tournaments, so that there is no motivation. You just play online open tournaments. There has to be national championship, because if you don't have any aim, no training, nothing. So if there is a national championship, people will prepare, and it is going to be some aim that I have to perform well to qualify. And even if this thing doesn't go, we are going to have this national championship. We are going to have online coaching camps for the people who are in the team, like top six of any national championship. We are going to have grandmaster coaching. All these things, program will alter our ways like normal chess.
So if when the calendar is released, people can find it on the AICF official website, yes?
Yes, it is AICF.in.
AICF.in is where the calendar will be updated. And do you think that at any point, the FIDE rating, the ELO, FIDE ELO rating, can get integrated with online chess, or that doesn't seem likely for now?
I know it was a big issue in our technical commission meeting also, but there were a lot of objections from serious players for the online. The reason is only cheating issues. So it was very difficult to do this, but maybe probably the way we are thinking that arbiter will monitor, probably will be able to convince FIDE to have our national championship as a rated tournament.
That would be wonderful. Bharat Singh ji, it was a pleasure talking to you. You patiently answered a lot of questions, a lot of things here for the past hour or so. And we are very grateful for your time. As you said, a lot of work needs to be done, and I wouldn't take more of your time. So wishing you all the best. And I would only say, on behalf of all the chess lovers of India and the chess fans, that we hope that AICF does a great job and chess prospers in the country.
Thank you. Thank you so much. This is our job to promote chess, and we'll keep doing it in a great way. Thank you. All the best.
Bye-bye. Well, that was AICF Secretary Bharat Singh Chauhan, who gave a broad outline about the vision of AICF for the next 3 years. I hope that through this interaction, many of you got an idea of what we can look forward to in the coming years from AICF. For me, it seems like there's so much that needs to be done for Indian chess, and I'm glad that dedicated people are working on this front, and I hope that they will continue doing this work. We'll wait and see how things pan out. It's a tough time also for the people who are in the administration because of the COVID situation, whether the online events have to be continued, whether over the board events have to begin. All of this has to be navigated carefully, and I'm sure that things will only improve from here. Thank you for being wonderful audience here and asking some very nice questions, giving some very good feedback, and I'll join you guys again very soon. This is Sagar Shah signing off. Bye-bye.